greetings from the nation's capital, where, as you can probably see, Congress is in recess while negotiations have stalled over an economic relief package for American businesses and workers. Now, as you'll read in this month's Advocacy Corner, AMSSM has been working up here on Capitol Hill with the Play Sports Coalition to encourage Congress to create a loan program for community youth sports programs, particularly small nonprofit parks and rec leagues, other community youth sports programs, to help them survive the current economic collapse within youth sports. This so-called youth sports loan program is based on the Paycheck Protection Act. The Paycheck Protection Program, which, as you recall, was passed a few months ago to help businesses maintain payrolls and jobs during the pandemic. However, since most youth sports leagues are staffed by parents and volunteers, the payroll provisions of the Payroll Protection Program don't really apply and don't solve the hardship that most youth sports programs are currently experiencing. So instead of basing the loan program on payroll, the COVID-19 Youth Sports and Working Families Relief Act would create a loan program based on lost receipts and operational expenses. And just like the Paycheck Protection Program, those loans would be forgivable if the program can document operation expenses and revenue losses, as well as demonstrate a return to activity after the pandemic, specifically based on youth sports participation. More information about that bill and ways that you can take action are in this month's Advocacy Corner. As of right now, making this video, Congress has not yet included the youth sports loan program into the larger relief package. In fact, all of the negotiations are completely deadlocked right now between the two sides. On one side here, you have the House of Representatives, which passed a $3 trillion relief package, and over here on the other side, the Senate passed a $1 trillion relief package. Now, if you remember from your high school government class, when both chambers of Congress pass legislation, they're supposed to get together to hammer out the differences. But this is an election year, and there are some political points to score, which you've probably seen play out on television. Plus, it's such a staggering amount of money. Even if they were to split the difference between $1 and $3 trillion, you're talking about a $2 trillion program that's added to the national debt. It really is a vexing problem for sure. But as it plays out, AMSSM will keep working to make sure Congress hears the concerns of youth sports. Also, as you'll see, there's several other issues in this month's Advocacy Corner, touching on proposed CMS telehealth regulations, an opportunity to dialogue with CDC about pain management, and some information about the Senate passage of the Empowering Olympic, Paralympic, and Amateur Athletes Act. As always, feel free to reach out if I can be of any assistance. Thanks for all you do.